We are back for homework. Reoccurring dream homework, that is. And, well, I might be late to the party, but I finally got my Buzembo to Omega. Got some sigils, got the minimum warps on her, but thankfully to the battle pass, if you pay for it and get to level 50, you can actually buy her Fangter. So that's what I did. And so I built her to be Tsukiyomi's, you know, support, because she can armor break and such, right? So we can actually want to put her to work, but might not be the best possible place. But you know what? We're going to actually make it work. So let's just get straight to it.
My talent, I can get even stronger.
The trash mob menace. So we're actually gonna fight this boss because he's slow, to be honest, and because of how Tsukiyomi actually works, right? I like the trash mob, but I'll probably be like get very boring after fight because all you ever do just go straight to the mob. So killing the trash does mix it up, but still annoying. Alright, Slowpoke. What? No way. Okay, who saw that? I didn't see that. I didn't see that coming. Honestly, I can't actually wait for the rebuilds for this character, because you don't have to worry about the, you know, rage meter all that much. Now get out of here with that. I need to get hit. He should not have hit. Sad AI, sad. This is gonna take a while, right? What? No way. You cheated, bro.
Nuh-uh.
Bad timing. Okay, we're gonna take the hits so we can actually just like do more damage in general. Or we're gonna be here a lot longer than we actually want to be here. Okay, finally, jeez. This guy's actually fairly armored, right?
Sword in your heart. Useless. Eclipse feathers scatter. Bun bun three attack. Slash.
Yes. It's okay. We got heals. Like, really?
Bun bun three, attack. Eclipse feathers, my scatter. Tower reading shows that you stay and I win.
Don't worry, we're gonna get Jingwu soon enough. So then we don't actually have to worry about fire, right? This boss is such a time waster.
I can get even stronger. Eclipse feathers, scatter. Eclipse feathers, scatter. I can do better than this.
Yeah, I didn't want to move out of that. Okay, I honestly did not want to move out of that. So. Alright, don't pay attention to those mess up. Welcome to the short girl team. So I just hey, why don't I just bring Heimdall with this team? And so I did that. Okay. More try. And it works surprisingly well. Surprisingly, these guys actually work a lot better than I was actually expecting them to work. What? You moved? Dude, come on. You waste my combo. Yeah. Give it to him. Teach you a lesson. Ah, I hate teleporters so much. Illuminate the verity. Ah, there. Well, you know the drill. He teleports, and you hit.
The impudent shall get that due.
I'm on to you. What? Holy moly. My girl, what are you doing all the way over here? Yeah, I'm gonna get out of that. I don't like confined spaces. Alright. Oh no! Are you gonna make it out? Maybe. Or maybe not. Doesn't matter. All right, let's go, Athena. Died too quickly. I wasted ultimate, right? So we're gonna get through it.
Congratulations, Jill.
All right, in you go again.
This is where your story ends.
Back in you go. And good night, sweet princess. Done.
Easy victory. Simple and boring.
Alright. That's done. Now, yeah, not so much on a wall hugger, right? I mean, dashing straight into the wall, having three melee range character. I didn't want to move out of a lot of the moves. Like, if I could, like, take the hit and just do more damage, because, yeah, the boss is so overbloated because it's, like, very overtuned. Because, yeah, as you may or may not know, the fire bosses are overtuned because of Jing Wu, which we're going to be getting very soon. So I'm looking forward to that. That means I can actually just steamroll these fire boss because they're all tuned for her of her incredible damage. This is why I said I am bringing Bozembo to somewhere that she probably shouldn't be. Now, their damage were fine, right? Their damage were fine. They were totally out of their elements, right? Everything was stacked against them. And they are not finished, especially when it comes to warp, would contribute a lot to their damages. But you know what? We get it done. Most of the mistakes were on my end, especially with Tsukiyomi Chain, because I have quite a bit of butterfinger of not using her, but running her as an AI control. So the whole timing thing is kind of a little out there for me, but I got it done. Took a long time, couldn't help it. After it was, you know, everything was done, I said, you know, maybe I should have actually just put them on the Thunder fight and just use, you know, Thor to deal with, you know, the defenders, like, seriously. But you know what? That's in hindsight. And we make up on the time on, you know, so Sound and Army Blade. We got it done in what, like a minute, 16, 18 seconds? And I really like that team because I managed to, like, say, okay, this team with, you know, Thor and, you know, Aesir and, well, now Heimdall. It actually works out very well for me, right? This is way more damage than my other team because both of them are able to actually get the damage buff from Heimdall's skill 3, which is fantastic, right? And everybody knows Soul Evolve, it's Shadow. If you have Hades, right, it's nothing. So that was that. Athena, you know my team. And that was also not an issue. Yeah. Everything was okay except Defender. Defender was actually something else, but it can't help. They were totally out of their element. Like, totally out of their element. But we actually got to see, like, raw damage, right? Raw damage that they actually do in comparison to each other. And it looks pretty good. Do look forward to the system where you're able to actually upgrade their function, which upgrade their skills, and do that. Especially for Tsukiyomi, it's gonna be fantastic. But you know what? Enough rumbling from me. I will see you guys in another one. Bye.